The world's largest man-made reef quickly became a large man-made fiasco.
It's a constant coral destruction machine.
In 1972, a group of private organizations dropped about 2 million automobile tires into the ocean off the coast of Fort Lauderdale, covering about 34 acres of the ocean floor. Their idea to create an artificial reef quickly turned bad as some tires began damaging nearby natural reefs. State and local government officials in Florida wanted to remove the tires for years, but they could never find a way to come up with the money to hire a private company to do the job, as much as $30 million. They were finally able to begin the cleanup this summer with just $2 million and the military. Army divers and equipment operators from Fort Eustis, Virginia, joined Navy and Coast Guard crew members in a combined training effort.
It makes us feel good that there's something else being accomplished besides just the diving itself, that we actually have a tangible goal to accomplish, and that's what we're working towards. We could see the fruits of our labor.
The services were brought together by Coastal America, a federal office designed to gather and manage federal agencies on marine projects. William Knuckles is the project coordinator for Coastal America. He says the massive cleanup never would have even started without the military.
These large-scale salvage jobs are really the military's expertise.
Knuckles says only the Army has the type of boat needed to store the tires once they're pulled out of the water.
Without that, the project really doesn't go forward.
The goal is to retrieve 700,000 tires from the ocean, which will probably take several years. Army divers tell me they want to continue on this project over the next few summers because it's good training and they're helping the environment. The only question is whether the units involved this summer will be available later. James Williams, Washington.